This Eucharistic celebration is aired live from the Cathedral Parish of San Roque, Diocese of Caloocan. This Requiem Mass is offered on the first death anniversary of Miss Karina Constantino David and for the intentions of her family and relatives who are joining us online. Our celebrant for this liturgy is Most Reverend Pablo Virgilio David Didi, the Bishop of Caloocan.
Come to the table, enter His presence, this thanksgiving and celebrate His love. Come to the table, enter His presence, this thanksgiving and celebrate His love.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Dear brothers and sisters, we offer this Mass in loving memory of our dearly departed Karina Constantino David. Let us now acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. To my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Almighty and merciful God, whose Son for our sake willingly underwent death in the flesh, grant mercifully, we pray, that your servant Karina may have part in the wondrous victory of Christ's resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples. On this mountain, He will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of His people He will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day, it will be said, "Behold, our God, to whom we look to save us. This is the Lord for whom we look. Let us rejoice and be glad that He has saved us." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, "The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want."
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. In verdant pastures, He gives me repose. Beside restful waters, He leads me. He refreshes my soul. He guides me in right paths for His name's sake.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for You are at my side with Your rod and Your staff that give me courage.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
Second reading. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, no one lives for oneself, and no one dies for oneself. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that He might be Lord of both the dead and the living. Why then do you judge your brother? Or you, why do you look down on your brother? For we shall all stand before the judgment seat of God. For it is written, "As I live, says the Lord, every knee shall bend before me, and every tongue shall give praise to God." So then, each of us shall give an accounting of himself to God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sing alleluia, sing alleluia, sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia, sing alleluia, sing alleluia to the Lord. Sing alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Amen, amen, I say to you, unless a grain of wheat falls to the ground and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Whoever loves his life will lose it. And whoever is ready to lose his life in this world will preserve it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me. And where I am, there also will my servant be. The Father will honor whoever serves me." Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good afternoon, everyone. In Kapampangan, we refer to the first death anniversary as Lucas Paldas. Literally, it means removing one's grieving clothes. Hubad luksa, para sa Kapampangan. But in Tagalog, they call it babang luksa. One time, I asked a friend of mine from Bulacan why they use the word baba instead of hubad. And he said, ang luksa para sa amin ay hindi lang yung isinusuot. Ito ay yung bumabalot sa buong buhay ng isang taong nawalan ng mahal sa buhay. Pati nga raw, mga bahay nila, binabalutan din nila ng paldang itim. And I remember that when I was much younger, na yung mga bahay ng namatayan ay binabalutan talaga ng itim. At hindi gaanong binubuksan ang mga bintana, hindi rin daw sinisindihan lahat ng mga ilaw kapag gabi. Tanda ng pagluluksa. Kaya sa pagtatapos ng isang taon ng pagluluksa, hindi lang ito hinuhubad. Ito'y literal na binababa. It is supposed to signal the readiness to start a new life, isang muling pagkabuhay. Somehow this makes me understand why we Filipinos have a different way of celebrating Easter. Kasi yung Easter eggs and Easter bunnies of Europeans and Americans do not mean very much to us. And so, we have reinvented our Easter and enculturated it as something like babang luksa. We prefer to dramatize it through our traditional salubong, the encounter between the risen Jesus and the sorrowful mother, which is facilitated by the coming down of an angel. The angel's task is to remove the black veil that covers the head of the Mater Dolorosa, of the sorrowful mother. And then the angel breaks into song and sings the Easter song, Regina Celi, which says, O Queen of Heaven, rejoice, Alleluia, for the Lord is risen indeed, Alleluia. Noong nakaraang linggo ng pagkabuhay, dahil panahon ng pandemya at wala kaming public celebrations, ako ho mismo ang naatasan na pumapel bilang angel. Nabanggit ko nga doon sa post ko, it was like a dream come true because long time ago pinangarap kong mapili na isabit din bilang anghel to remove the black veil of Mama Mary. When I did it, I imagined her to be our country or the whole world today, knowing how a veil of grief has descended upon us and covered our lives since the start of the pandemic crisis that has locked us all down in our homes. Believe it or not, this babang luksa motif is not peculiar to us Filipinos. It is in fact what we hear from our first reading today. Isaiah chapter 25. The prophet says, on this mountain God will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is covering over the nations. He will destroy death forever. What a beautiful prophecy. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces. The reproach of His people He will remove from the whole earth because the Lord has spoken, says the prophet. Last Friday, when Kuya Randy sent me by email the advanced copy of his Sunday column for the Philippine Daily Inquirer, and he does that regularly, where he, in that column, he reminisced the painful death, the painful day of the passing of Karina on May 7, 2019, last year. But when I got his email, I took it as a signal that he was sort of asking me in a roundabout way if I could celebrate Mass for Ate Nin's first death anniversary. Thank God for digital technology. At least now we're able to come together virtually. I was really hoping that in spite of this COVID pandemic, we would be able to accompany our kuya and his family in the ritual of Babang Luksa. You know, if not for this lockdown, it would have come with a big Kapampangan meal after Mass. Pasensya na ho, wala muna ngayon. All of you, family and friends of Kuya, know how grief had descended upon my brother and his children when Karina died. I saw how it had covered his life like a dark veil. Well, later, before the end of this Mass, Kuya Randy will share his thoughts about grieving and what it now means to him. I do not mean to preempt Kuya Randy's speech, but I want you to please listen carefully to the words that he will quote from that Italian writer Carlo Rovelli in order to find the words to express what grieving is about. But imagine how much more painful the grieving must have been for people who have lost their loved ones to the COVID-19 in the past few weeks. Can you imagine the thought of letting your loved one die alone? Imagine not being allowed to even kiss or touch them. Imagine saying goodbye to them through a cell phone. Not being able to hold a proper wake in order to mourn together as a family. And having to have your loved one cremated within 12 hours. All of it is unthinkable in Filipino culture. I know somebody who lost her husband to COVID-19 just a few days ago. She gave me her own description of grief. This is what she said to me. She said, "You feel like there is a thick smoke that darkens your view. And you think it is there outside of you. It takes a while before you realize it is inside you, in your mind, in your heart and soul. You try to force a smile to your friends, but you cannot keep the tears from giving you away." Her description reminds me of that song of the Platters. You remember that song, "Smoke Gets in Your Eyes"? It speaks about a love who has flown away. The song says, "Now, laughing friends deride, tears I cannot hide. So I smile and say, when a lovely flame dies, smoke gets in your eyes." I don't know why we often find ourselves apologizing when grief makes us break into tears. I remember what Pope Francis said to Filipinos when he visited us in 2015. You remember that scene at UST when he was unable to answer the question of that little girl who broke down before him after posing the question, "Why does God allow young people to suffer abuse?" The Pope himself just cried. And then he embraced the little girl. But later he said, sometimes God helps us to see more clearly with eyes washed by tears. To see more clearly with eyes washed by tears. Please watch the video later after communion, after the final prayer. It was prepared by Cara in memory of her mother. And please look closely at what is written on Karina's gravestone as an epitaph. The epitaph reads, "A life joyfully lived in self-forgetting service." And it is what I invite the family and friends to see more clearly with eyes washed by tears. Incidentally, it is also what our second reading from Romans 14 is saying. Listen, none of us lives for oneself, and none of us dies for oneself. Do the words ring a bell to you? Of course they do, because you keep singing those lines in the church, but in Tagalog, walang sino man ang nabubuhay para sa sarili lamang. Walang sino man ang namamatay para sa sarili lamang. This is a declaration that will make sense only to a believer who, in my simpler definition, is one who aspires not just to live, but to live meaningfully, to live with mission and purpose. Actually, what St. Paul is saying here is not always true, and I react to it sometimes, because there are people who live only for themselves. There are people in this world who die for themselves. And I must say, what a senseless death that must be. Because it proceeds from a senseless life. When it ends, there is nothing else that follows. There is no hope for eternity. How can one even aspire for a meaningful death if one has not first of all aspired for a meaningful life? Karina's secret to living life joyfully is self-forgetting service. You know, I can relate to that because it is my own motto as a bishop, kenosis, the total emptying of self that is required of people who wish to live life to the full. I cannot recall anymore who it was who said, "That which is to give light must endure burning." But Jesus would have said that differently. He would have said, "He who offers himself as bread of life must be ready to be broken, to be shared, and to be consumed." I was just in college the first time I read a poem about death by Edmond Rostand. And it imagines a conversation between Cyrano de Bergerac and his beloved Roxane. And Cyrano points at the trees that are ablaze in the season of autumn. He says, "Look at the leaves." And Roxane, she looks up. And she's amazed, and she says, "Oh, what color! Perfect Venetian red. Look at them fall." And Cyrano now looks at Roxane. And he says, "Yes, they know how to die. A little way from the branch to the earth, and a little fear of mingling with common dust. And yet, they go down gracefully, a fall that seems like flying." I think I can say that Karina knew how to die because she knew how to live. She had so much faith in life itself and what it does if you can live it joyfully in self-forgetting service. It removes your fear of death. Only people who have wasted their lives, people who have lived life meaninglessly, who will be terrified by death. In our gospel, Jesus describes death even better. Not just like leaves falling, but like seeds falling on the ground. He says, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a grain of wheat. But if it dies, it produces much fruit. Well, to whomever Karina has shared her life, and I know there are many of you out there now following this celebration, she allowed her life to fall like seeds. And it does not take very much to see where those seeds have germinated well and are now still bearing much fruit. Let me end with Kuya Randy's thoughts. In that column that Kuya Randy wrote last Sunday, which he entitled, Old Enough to Die, he concluded his thoughts with the following words. When Karina died, I began to reflect on the purpose of it all. Why we ever live. What it is to be human. And why people we love who have gone ahead ever appeared in our world. And how their lives enriched ours. Karina knew my love for motorcycles, says Kuya. And she never stopped me from pursuing this dangerous sport. Ingat ka, she would whisper, every time I had to leave her bedside early in the morning for a ride. And she'd follow up and say, call or text me, okay, when you're on your way home. And Kuya concludes, I still hear these words whenever I go out of my motorcycle, on my motorcycle, assured in the thought that while I may be old enough to die, I should never be too old to remember what it means to live and be happy. You can repeat that like a mantra. Old enough to die, but never too old to remember what it means to be happy.
Please rise.
Dear brothers and sisters, too often we stray from the Lord's ways. Let us ask Him for the strength to live lives of faith. Let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. That those who exercise leadership in the church may keep their commitment alive in the preaching of the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those invested with authority may lead and guide the people in the spirit of service. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those who have abandoned their faith may be led back to the family of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That those disheartened by suffering and sickness may find strength and consolation from Jesus who was victorious over sin and death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the faithful departed, especially for Karina, whose first death anniversary we celebrate today, be raised up to eternal joy in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Almighty Father, you call us to be with you. May we be faithful in following your Son on the way to your kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Lord, we gather today. In your arms we leave down and pray. We ask for your mercy as we open our hearts to receive your forgiveness, O Lord. As we offer this bread, bring everything this one. Bless them, Lord Jesus, fill us now, give us love. Send us your Spirit, the source of our life, and together we will serve you with love.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be attentive, O Lord, to our prayers for your servant Karina, whose anniversary we observe today. And through this sacrifice of conciliation and praise, graciously add her to the company of your saints through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, so that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, your faithful Lord, for your faithful people, life is changed and not ended. When this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in your kingdom. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest, Hosanna in the highest.
Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Until you come again, we proclaim your death, O Lord.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and your servant, the bishop of this diocese, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Karina, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and with San Roque, our patron saint, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen, 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 amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Forgive us trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us, deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the
Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. As we cannot receive the Lord sacramentally, let us pray the prayer for spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself fully to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray.
Please stand.
Having received the sacrament of your only begotten Son, who was sacrificed for us and rose in glory, we humbly implore you, O Lord, for your departed Karina, that cleansed by the Paschal mysteries, she may glory in the gift of the resurrection to come. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And now, we will show you the video that was produced by Cara David in memory of her mother. And then after the short video, you will also hear the Thanksgiving speech of my brother, Randy David. Please watch it.
Ordinary people, especially on Filipinos.
Nagsimula po kami pumunta sa kalsada noong mga late 70s.
Do not just say, as they used to tell us in the past. Ipapanalo muna natin yung revolusyon at saka na yung babae. That cannot be. Because one half of the world has to be part of the change. If we are not, then that is not change.
Akala na rin, nag-retiro na kami. Kaya pinagpapalit yung Olympic naman yan sa palasyo. Medyo tinakapos na rin ang hinira, kailangan namin bumalik. Sakit lang para makasama kayo.
Ganito yung nararamdaman ko, taus puso,
pasasalamat, paghangad ng kapayapaan para sa lahat ng mga tapat na naglingkod sa sambayanan, sa lahat ng kawani, sa inyong mga pamilya. Taos puso, pasalamat.
I'd like to begin by thanking everyone who has mourned with us during this past year when step by step and while still in a daze, we, my children and their spouses, my grandchildren, the rest of our extended family and myself all had to pick up our lives soon after Karina's mortal remains were brought to their final resting place. Your kindness and generosity, your soothing expressions of sympathy, your prayers and warm embraces, all these gave us the strength we needed to be able to come to terms with Karina's untimely passing. She had been for us such a steady, comforting, and reassuring presence throughout her life that we have spent much of this past year usually second-guessing what she would have liked us to do whenever we had a problem or a situation to deal with that needed quick thinking and a fair resolution. Karina was many things to us, but she has been most missed in our everyday lives as the patient listener, the generous advice giver, and the tireless problem solver par excellence. Those who have gone through the experience of losing a loved one would know that what the mind tells you is often not immediately accepted by the heart. The complex emotions that result from this dissonance is, I think, what grieving is about. I have gone through the different stages that the author Elizabeth Kubler-Ross associates with death and grieving. Denial, anger, depression, resignation, and finally acceptance. But just when I have convinced myself that I am healed, I sometimes find myself back again in first stage, in what seems like an endless cycle of sorrow and pain. The most difficult part of grieving for me has not been the inability to let go of a loved one. It is rather the profound realization that there is nothing more you can do to explain yourself to someone who has gone. Thus, the hardest emotions of all, regret and guilt. Regret over things left unfinished or unsaid, and guilt over deeds that cannot be undone, words that cannot be taken back, and feelings that cannot be explained, justified, or erased. You wake up each day asking, how do you get over this absence? I have found some solace in some of the books I have been reading in this period of prolonged quarantine. The Italian writer and physicist Carlo Rovelli in his book, The Order of Time, best explains the feelings I have just described. Here is what he says. But it is an absence that causes sorrow. It is affection and love. Without affection, without love, such absences would cause us no pain. For this reason, even the pain caused by absence is, in the end, something good and even beautiful, because it feeds on that which gives meaning to life. We, whose lives have been touched and enriched by Karina, can only be grateful to her for having shown us what it means to love, to live a life of self-forgetting service, and to be able to face the unknown with serenity and grace. A full year has passed, but there has not been a day when I haven't thought of you. Rest in peace, my dearest Nils.
So thank you, dear friends, dear family, for joining us online for this celebration in memory of our beloved Karina. And we pray for her eternal repose. Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her. May she rest in peace. Amen. May her soul and the souls of the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Para sa sarili lamang, walang sinuman ang namamatay para sa sarili lamang. Tayong lahat ay may pananagutan sa isa't isa. Tayong lahat ay tinipon ng Diyos na kapiling